This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Put together eight guys, a broomstick, and this.
Literally, half a ball.
And you're back in the 60s.
Brings me back to when I was young.
Collect callers from every era.
The first car phone.
1958.
And we talk about texting and driving.
And one man's passion becomes a telephone museum.
The first comment is, what's a phone booth?
Let Ted Reinstein roam, and you'll be amazed at what he finds.
The lathe turns the wood as I carve it.
The painstaking art of a wood turner.
Anything worth it takes a while, right?
The Bay State's Birdman. Plus, in Franklin, the case of the missing bell. Who knew is next on Chronicle.
Good evening. Who says you have to put away the games of childhood when you become an adult? Not Ted Reinstein. Ted found a group of men in East Boston who found a way to be kids again, thanks to half a ball.
This story is a little like baseball. Well, 50% like baseball. Literally, half a ball.
It's not new, and at first glance, you'd assume you were looking at stickball, that time-honored urban tradition. Basically, baseball for small spaces, no grass, and no real equipment, except a broomstick and a rubber ball. The broomstick bats are the same here, but about the ball. Welcome to half ball.
This game goes back a long way. We picked it up when we were kids. In the 1960s, 70s, and early 80s. And that's how we continued on.
A few years ago, East Boston native Bill O'Brien organized some friends to reconnect over a casual game of outdoor half ball. The response was so great that one pickup game has now grown into an organized league of half a dozen teams, complete with tournaments and trophies.
You could play this anywhere. Improvise, put down some tape, make some lines, have a couple of guys there, and have a ball for a couple of hours.
Oh, they have a ball, all right. On a weekday afternoon, we dropped in on the action at Eastie's Martin Pino Community Center. It's 4-on-4. Each team fields a pitcher, catcher, and two fielders. After that, it's like it was back in the neighborhood. Mom supplied the bat, whether she knew it or not.
My mother used to say to me, I hope that ain't my broomstick. Oh, no, Ma, it's not. It's not. We're going out. Don't worry about it.
The ground rules? All depends on the neighborhood.
You stop the ball from hitting that back wall, it's an out. You don't
have to catch it. If it hits the wall on the ground, it's a single.
It's a single. Dark blue is a double.
Yeah.
Light blue is a home run.
Yeah.
The glass and above is an automatic home run.
Hitting a home run with a half ball is harder than it looks. Hitting it at all isn't easy. Trust me.
That half ball is harder to hit than a full ball.
Much harder. Much harder.
This guy whacked a ball into infinity, right out the door. Not sure what the ground rule is on that one. The crowds are sparse, but appreciative and mostly related.
Whoa. Now batting for the living legend, Jim Napolitano.
Half ball is having a bit of a revival, starting with the famed pimple ball itself being back in production again, along with a new book about the sport. It's unclear who first had the devious idea of cutting the hollow ball in half, but it was diabolically brilliant.
Oh, that ball could be coming in like this. That ball could be coming in like this. That could dive on you real easy. Guys can really throw this ball.
I didn't look like one of those guys on this pitch. Ooh, that had to sting. Not that they don't take their stats seriously here, but the truth is, pitching and hitting aside, for a lot of these guys of a certain age, that's not what draws them here.
So, you guys go back, huh?
Yes, we go back about 50 years. We played Little League together. Played on the same team, and then we hooked up through this, and what this is unbelievable.
What do you love about it?
What I love about it is it brings me back to when I was young, and this place has brought back my youth.
The lure of half ball here has also drawn some guys who still have their youth.
Came in here and I saw that there were a lot of them a lot older than me. I'm like, are we kind of interfering here? I mean, I don't know if this is a nostalgia thing, but they loved it. They loved that the game's being passed on. They love it. And you know what? You don't have to be 30 years old to play. The 60-year-old, they're striking me out all the time. I love this. Every other week, it's great.
Things did start to come back to me, though. I won't say how many swings that took. And my pitching improved enough to groove one right down the middle for Bill O'Brien.
guy, right in your wheelhouse.
It might be half a ball, but it's kind of come full circle for these sluggers.
We all knew each other when we were 12 years old. We're all on different parts of East Boston. Who was on the corner here, who was at the schoolyard there. And then we all grew up. We all had our families, and then we reconnected. You would think that we were 14 years old again.
Kind of like a half ball, field of dreams.
Eastie half ball!
The half ball league, the only one in the city, by the way, takes the summer off. Then players come back in the fall for an outdoor tournament in September at Shades Beach in East Boston. And you don't have to be a child of the 60s to play. The league is open to anyone who is interested. As for the tradition of stickball, you may know this. When the young Willie Mays was playing for the then New York Giants, he used to stop and play stickball with kids in the streets of Harlem. Well, to save his marriage, Vincent Valentine created a museum.
The entire collection is his.
I donated it to the museum.
This is after your wife insisted you get this stuff out of the house, right?